好，大家好，那好，我们就开始了哈。题目你们已经看见了，我今天主要是我们以圣经为依据，看一下我们做父母的，应该怎么样？其实不光是影响孩子哈，圣经上教导我们怎么样哈？我们当然我们最关心的是影响我们的孩子，但圣经上教导的远远不止影响我们的孩子哈。我看一下，我是不是在？OK，我在录，非常好。好，今天呢，我会用《生命记》哈，6章4到9节来讲。So, we as Chinese parents, we care the most of is our children, right? But the Bible tell us more than that. So today I'm going to use Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 through 9 to see what God's command to us. Okay. 首先我要介绍一下这一段的这个圣经的背景啊，介绍的目的是让大家看见这一段在圣经中是非常重要的。First, I would like to present the background of this paragraph of the scripture so that we can see how important it is in the Bible. 这一段圣经是在以色列人在旷野40年后进迦南地之前，摩西对年轻一代的以色列的讲话，是摩西五经中上帝命令的总结。So this is a discourse that Moses delivered to the young generation of Israelites after they spent 40 years in the desert before they march into the land of Canaan. So this is a summary of all the laws of God's command in the Pentateuch. Okay, so it is very important in the Bible. Okay, first let's read the Bible. 我们先来读一下这段圣经哈。生命记6章4到9节，以色列啊，你要听，耶和华我们的神是独一的神。你要尽心、尽性、尽力爱耶和华你的神。我今日所吩咐你的话，你都要记在心上，也要殷勤教训你的儿女。无论你坐在家里、行在路上、躺下起来，都要谈论，也要系在手上为记号，戴在额上为经文，又要写在你房屋的门框上，并你的城门上。Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 through 9.Hear, all Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. And these words that I command you today shall be on your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children and shall talk of them when you sit in your house and when you walk by the way and when you lie down and when you rise.You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. And you shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Okay. 好，这一段圣经呢，我把它按着步骤，循序渐进的步骤，把它分成了六步。我会讲在穿这讲六步的时候，我会讲美国现在我们生活的这个环境是怎么回事哈。Okay, this paragraph of scripture. So I divide them into 6 steps. Okay, and I will go into them in details later on. And in the process, I will also share with you the.Current situation in the United States, what our children and we are facing. Okay. 好，我们来看一下，它有六步。第一就是，第一我们就要自己要信主。我要谈一下信主意味着什么。So the step one is we have to trust the Lord. I will actually go into detail what trusting the Lord mean. Okay.第二步就是三观必须被归正哈。我们说我们是基督徒，我们的三观必须要被我们的信仰所改变。Okay, the second step is our worldview our value system and the purpose of our life must be transformed by our faith in Jesus Christ. 好，第三步呢，就是对我们自己来讲，你看见没有？前面三步其实都是我们个人要做的什么事哈。第三步就是 to in 第三步是确保持续性，也就是说 in the step three is to ensure consistency and persistence. As you can see, the first three steps are all what we should do as a person before we influence others. Okay. 第四步是传递给孩子 to pass on to your children.And then 第五步是传递给他人 to pass on to others. 第六步是传递给社区和社会 to influence the community and society and the government. OK. 好，我们从第一步哈。我们圣经上这个说的非常清楚。第一步 Deuteronomy chapter 六章四节，以色列，你要听耶和华我们的神是独一的主。这Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. 这个其实跟我们现在说的你要信耶稣是一回事，真的是一回事。因为你现在我们，你想想这个罗马书，十章九到十节说什么？你若口里称耶稣为主，心里信他从死里复活就必得救，因为人口里相信就可以称义，心里承认就可以得救。这一段其实就是在讲信耶稣。信耶稣不光是要说耶稣是你的救主，耶稣必须是你的主。其实你看见没有，这一句话就是生命记六章四节跟这个新约里面讲的信耶稣其实是一回事，是一回事哈。 OK, Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 4It says we have to believe, we have to trust our God as the only Lord of us. Okay, it's basically the same as as for Christians who become a Christian. I mean, as for us who become a Christian, like Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10, you have to confess Jesus as your Lord and then with your mouth, and then you have to believe that he resurrected from death in your heart. This is a parallelism. So basically they enhance each other. They complement each other and enhance each other. Okay. 好。尊耶稣，尊上帝为我们的主。旧约是上帝为我们的主，耶和华我们的主。新约是尊耶稣为我们的主。它是什么意思呢？尊他为我们的主，也就是说我在我的世界观，我要相信他掌管一切。不光是相信，真的是活出来。Okay, what does it mean to trust God or in New Testament, trust Jesus as our Lord? First, in our worldview, we have to believe that he controls everything, including me and you, everybody. I mean, everything, everybody. Okay, and 第二个的是，他的话必须是我的是非的最高标准。And then second, his word must be the ultimate standard for me to live my life. Okay? 这是我们的价值观。Okay? 第三个就是我的人生观就是 to glorify him. Glorify him must be the purpose of my life. 就是说荣耀他认识他必须是我的人生的目标。我把这说完以后你就会发现其实我们很多我们信耶稣的人其实我们就没有打算这样信耶稣的。我不知道你想过没有，我们很多信耶稣啊、哦，我是个罪人，耶稣救我，哎呀，我该干啥就干啥，我还是我以前的世界观、价值观、人生观，我想喜欢什么就喜欢什么，我想干什么就是干什么。你看见没有？当我讲这个时候，其实你要重新检查一下，你是不是真的信耶稣。See, as I go through this, you really have to examine your faith, because for in the past few decades of years, when we preach in the gospel, we only tell them they need to accept Jesus as their personal savior because they are sinners. Once they accept Jesus, they do whatever they want. They still keep their affection, their passion, their purpose of life. Now when I tell you this, I mean, when the Bible tells you that, when I show you this, you really have to examine yourself. Are you a true believer? Are you a true believer of Christ? 看见没有？其实这个是一个非常严肃的问题。我自己这些年做辅导，我做了好多年辅导，做了很多年的这个福音事工，我这些年一直在反省，在检查我自己。我其实发现我们以前很多传福音都传错了。为什么？我们传福音的时候，我们从来不强调耶稣是主。其实你看这个罗马书10:9-10说得非常清楚，信耶稣不光是耶稣是你的救主，耶稣必须是你的主。I examine myself, I evaluate, I mean, the gospel I've been preaching in the past almost 30 years. And then I've been correcting myself along these years because I realized that in the past, the gospel I was preaching was not in line with the Bible. We usually only focus on Jesus is our Savior. The Bible says very clearly in the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 9 and 10, that we have to confess Jesus as our Lord. And Lord means our worldview, our value system, and our purpose of life have to be changed accordingly, have to be transformed accordingly. Okay. 好，你怎么测一下耶稣是不是你的主呢？How do you find out whether Jesus is your Lord or God is your Lord? 你就会想想 ,what is your state? 你的是非标准是圣经吗？还你的是非标准是圣经还是你的文化你的传统你的教育或者你的感觉 ?Okay,to find out whether Jesus is your Lord, I mean, just think about what is your standard of right and wrong? It's based on the Bible?Or based on your culture, your tradition, your education, or your personal feeling. 我发现了，我跟很多基督徒谈过，很多有各种各样问题的，因为我做辅导嘛，所以我天天遇到的就是有问题的。根本的问题哈，基督徒遇到的根本的问题就是耶稣不是他们的主。他们的是非标准是文化，是传统，是教育，或者是感觉。OK, in theyears of biblical counseling, I mean, most people I have been helping, but they have difficulty in their life. And then most of them, I found out is the reason they got into the trouble because Jesus is really not their Lord. And then Jesus is not the standard of their right and wrong. And their standard of right and wrong has been their culture, their tradition, their education, or their personal feeling.That's why they get into all these kinds of troubles. Okay. 好，我还有很多其他的问题啊，这个地方我就不问了。我只是特别要问一下，就是还有你期望你的孩子在哪方面成功，其实就能够显示出谁是你的主。Yeah, there are many questions that I put on this PPT. You can read them yourself. But there's one indicator that can tell whether you have Jesus as your Lord is.What is your expectation for your children? What is the success you have, you expect in your children? That is an indicator whether Jesus is your Lord. So whether you want your children or your child to be a person who will follow Jesus as the purpose of their life, or you want your children to be a successful person in the world,就是说你期望你的孩子在世界上成功是按照耶稣的标准还是按照世人的标准其实这就能够看得出来你是不是真的是尊耶稣为主、啊、第一个这个非常重要因为我在以后讲的东西的话我每次讲我都会反过来回到 这一点 OK whether Jesus is your Lord is very important throughout my presentation so later on I will constantly refer to thisBack. This is the core of our faith. 这真是我们信仰的核心哈。好，哦，现在我们就开始讲第二点。第二点就是说，当我信耶稣以后，我的三观必须要被归正。也就是说，once I become a Christian, once I regard Jesus, accept Jesus as my Savior and my Lord, my worldview, my value system, and my purpose of life really have to be transformed.Of course, it's a process gradually, you know, by my faith in Christ. Okay, so in the woman, then the sin of Yesu, woman, Sanguan, be sure, Gabin. Shushua, Wogan Han, Dohan, 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 Wogan, Rogan, Gatan, you know, there's a one sham, Shua. 其实我发现这个基督徒的普遍的问题现在都是，可能我信了耶稣，我去教会，我参加一些教会的活动，我做一些事儿，但是呢，我的三观根本就没改变，跟我的信仰没有关系。Okay, so I found this many, many times, you know, with Christians that I chat with every day, because that's what I do, you know. And I think it's very common that I would see more than 50% of Christians I talk with. Once they become a Christian, they probably add upon what they are doing, some things they do. They go to church and they start to sing in the choirs, and then they do some activity, Christian activity, but their worldview, their value system, and their purpose of life has not been changed by their faith at all. That's the problem. Okay.这个也是，这个因为我要讲会讲很长时间，我就不讲了，我可以给你们以后看哈。I do not want to expand on the second point because of the time constraint. Okay, 我只想稍微说一下。I just touch it a little bit. Okay, 生命记六章五节说你要尽心、尽性、尽力。爱主你的神，尽心就是你的 heart， 你的 heart。So, Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 5 said, "You need love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might." Heart 的话，就是我们人生是心里最深的这个角落。OK， 最深的这个角落，其实它像人是隐藏的，像我们自己是半隐藏的，只有上帝看得见。OK， our heart, that's the deepest, the most inner being of us, okay? It's hidden from others, and it's semi-hidden from us. It's only transparent in front of God, okay? 但是呢，我们的情感和我们的感觉其实是我们心的窗口，其实你可以去借着你的感觉，你的感情，看一下你的心。However, our affection, our feeling is the small window of our heart.Even though we can't really perceive our heart, but our feeling. So, 这就是为什么你如果注意一下，你为什么高兴，为什么愤怒，为什么焦虑，其实那就是你的世界观、价值观、人生观的反应。Okay, so examine yourself to see where you spend your emotion. What and who.Will stir up your emotion, your affection. That's an indicator of your worldview, of your what you value the most, and what's your purpose of life. Okay, 我就讲到这个地方。上帝跟我们说，要我们尽心的爱上帝，也就是说，我要把我的感情全部调动起来爱上帝。Okay, what about the 感情? Okay, the Lord said we have to love Him with all of our heart, which means we need to mobilize, we need to control our emotion and our feeling to submit them to the Lord. Okay, 这个是需要花功夫的啊，这是上帝说对我们个人来讲对我们的要求。Okay, so that takes effort and time. This is the command that God have.Among us as an individual, okay. 好，第二个他说我们要尽信啊，尽信就是soul， 信是什么？就是性质啊，生命啊，你的琐事啊，你的身份呐、啊，你的定位啊 ，okay. Second, the Lord said we have to love Him with all of our soul. Soul means entirety of a person, entirety of a person, your life.Your being, your identity, how others view you. I mean, when they see you, what's their first impression about you? Okay. 美国的这个副总统彭斯哈、啊，他就是我们州以前的州长，印第安纳哈。我认识一些他的私人朋友，大家都对他的信仰和他的品格赞不绝口。他说过一句这样的话，他说，我首先是一个基督徒，再是一个保守主义者。 然后再才是一个共和党人。Okay, the vice president, Michael Pence, he used to be our governor. I live in Indiana. So I know several of his personal friends who know him for many, many years. They speak highly of his faith in Christ and his character, his morality and his character. He once said, his identity is, he described himself first as a Christian and second as a conservative and third as a Republican. He said in that order, 他说他就是按照这个顺序来给他自己定位，这是他的身份哈。他这个说的是非常好哈，他不光这样说，我不是说了吗？我认识他的很多朋友，人家说他也是这样活出来。So his identity is really biblical. So not only he said that, but also several of his personal friends said that he actually lived that. He not only talk the talk, he also walk the walk. Okay. 好，第三个就是我们要尽力，尽力就是 with all, 尽力就是用你所有的力气，比方说你热切的做事，你快速的做事，你殷勤的做事，你仔细的做事，看见没有，他是讲你的 doing, 就是讲你的做，就 okay. So the third is love the Lord with all of our might. Might means we do it eagerly, rapidly, diligently, and then,carefully, so it's about our doing. So summarize the second point is we love the Lord with all of our heart, all of our soul, all of our might, from inside to outside, from the root to the fruits, from the invisible to the visible, and totally and completely we love the Lord. Okay, 所以这是上帝对父母，对我们做父母的要求。This is the requirement God has for us as parents, as individuals. Okay. 好，第三呢，圣经说我们要确保这个连续性。比方说我信主啊，他总是我的主啊，我的三观被改正的，我必须要有这个连续性，重复性和连续性，是不是 ？Okay, the third.Is I have to ensure the consistency and the persistence of my faith in the Lord. I have to ensure the consistency and the persistence of my worldview, value system, and my purpose for life. How do I do that? 我怎么做呢？圣经上说，这就是《申命记》六章六节，说我今日吩咐你的话，你都要记在心上。记在心上说，就是说。God command us that we must keep His word in our heart. 怎么样？怎么样做？怎么样做？就像你，就像我们各个地方有水库呀。你们在 Minnesota， 你们不需要水库。Minnesota 是万湖之州。You live in Minnesota, you do not need need a reservoir. 但是呢，我住在这个。印第安纳，我们这个地方地真的是很 boring 的，非常枯燥。我们这个地方几乎没有天然的湖啊，几乎没有天然的湖。I live in Indiana. It's such a boring place. It's all plain. No natural lakes. Okay. 那我们怎么办？所以我们这个地方每一次做一个社区的话，建筑商就会一定在这个社区根据它的大小会挖几个蓄水池，否则的话一下雨就会涨水。 OK, so in a land like Indiana, so the builders, when they start to build a subdivision, they have to first dig out water pump. Otherwise, if there's a rain, there will be flood. OK, 所以呢，这个水库其实就像我们基督徒，我们平时读圣经，我们背圣经，我们思想圣经一样。This water reservoir, just like a Christian, when we spend time daily to read the Bible, to study the Bible, to memorize the Bible, to meditate the Bible, so that we can keep God's word in our heart. 我们只有像这样的话，我们平时多思想神的话，我才能够把神的话记在心上。OK, 所以看见没有，这是父母怎么准备自己。See, this is how we, as parents, as adults, how we prepare ourselves first. 有没有发现一般的基督徒都不下功夫读圣经？ Have you found out that most Christians do not spend enough effort in memorizing, keeping God's word on our heart? 这就是为什么他们遇到问题就傻眼了。That's why every time when they run into problem, they're in panic. 因为他没有准备自己，看见没有？因为他平时没有下功夫准备自己。Because they did not prepare themselves. They did not have water in their reservoir prepared for a drought day. Can you see that? 就是水库里的水就是要留在那儿，平时雨多的时候你就挤在那儿，干旱的时候你就拿出来用，有需要的时候你就拿出来用。 Okay, like the water in the reservoir. When there's rain, when the river running, when the creek is running, you collect the water, and then you use the water when there's a drought, when there's many days without rain, when there's a trouble. 所以我真的是要鼓励你们要读圣经啊，鼓励你们，尤其是你的孩子还小的话。I really want to encourage you. I urge you that you really have to study your Bible every day, especially when your children are still young. Okay. 如果你的孩子现在大了，你就可以跟他一起学习。你告诉他以前你没有学，很抱歉了，现在开始。If your children are early, grow up, okay? You just tell them you made a mistake. You need to, if you did not study the word enough, you need to spend a lot of time, and you will spend a lot of time study God's word, okay? 在这个基础下，我才跟你讲下面的, okay? On top of that, we will move on to the next. 我看我有没有时间讲一个见证, okay? I think I will have a little time to tell you my story. Okay. 我90年到92年我在 Duluth 读硕士。Duluth, Minnesota, okay. From 90 to 92, I was pursuing my master in Duluth, Minnesota. 92年到96年我就到 Twin City 读化学博士。And from 92 to 96, I was pursuing my PhD in chemistry in Twin City, Minnesota. 就在我读博士前三天，我生了一个儿子。哎，记住，那个时候是没有人帮助我，就是我们夫妇俩，我们俩同时读博士。OK， 所以你可以想象那个生活是非常的艰辛哈。In 92, 3 days before I started my PhD program in Twin City, I had my first son. We had no help from our parents. My husband and I, we both are in PhD program. As you can imagine, how stressful our life were. 我非常感恩那个时候马天南大哥，那个时候他还不是牧师，来门徒造就我。I was very thankful to God and to Brother Stephen Ma. At that time, he was not a pastor yet. He came to our house. He asked us if we are willing to be discipled by him. 第一天他来我们家，他就跟我们讲说你们要读圣经啊，读圣经很重要。 On the first day of the disciple training, he told us that we have to spend time study God's word. And he told us why that is so important. 然后他就给了我们一个计划，然后跟我说，他说如果你一天读四章圣经，他说你一个星期读24章，你一年就可以把圣经读完一遍。 And he told us, he said, if you read 4 chapters every day of the Bible, and then only 24 chapters, not 28, 24 chapters a week, and you will go through the Bible once a year. 然后他看着我们，他问我们，他说你准备每年读几遍圣经？ Then he looked at us, and then he said,How many times you want to read through the Bible every year? 我那个时候根本不知道读圣经是咋回事，而且我刚才说了，我非常忙碌，我刚刚开始读博士。At that time, I have not systematically read through the Bible yet. And I had no idea how much it takes to read the Bible. And as I just mentioned earlier, my life was so stressed out because I just started PhD program with a baby. Okay. 所以呢,我就看着马大哥,我说,你能不能说一下你每年把圣经读几遍? So I looked at Brother Mark. I said, could you please tell me how many times you go through the Bible every year? 马大哥说他一年浏览圣经20遍。 我非常羡慕马大哥的生命。 他的生命真的是有耶稣基督的馨香。 Okay, Brother Mark told us that he glanced through the Bible 20 times a year. At that time, I admire Brother Mark's life so much. I think his life is full of the fragrance of Jesus Christ. I want to mimic him. 我想模仿马大哥。所以呢，我就跟马大哥说，我说呢，我准备每天读6章旧约，6章新约。 再加一张箴言。So I told Brother Ma, I said, Stephen Ma, Brother Stephen Ma, I said, I decide I will read 6 chapters of the Old Testament, 6 chapters of the New Testament, and 1 chapter of the Proverb every day. 他说,非常好,记下来。And he said, that is great, write it down. So I wrote it down. 所以我就写了我周小琴1993年某月某日，我决定每天读6章旧约6章新约。So I wrote it down on my disciple training booklet. I said, I周小琴decide I will read 6 chapters of Old Testament, 6 chapters of New Testament every day. And then 他又问我老公，我老公也说了一个计划。 Then he asked my husband. My husband also gave a plan. He asked my husband to write it down in the disciple training book. 然后他就告诉我们说，人本性罪恶，你是不喜欢读圣经的。但是呢，你要坚持，就像你吃饭一样。所以呢，我会每次看见你，我就问你，一直到你养成习惯。Then he told us, he said, human nature do not like the Bible because we are sinful. But we have to train ourselves to read the Bible just like we train the children to eat healthy food. Until he said he will remind us every week until we form a habit, until a habit is formed. 所以我从那个时候到现在,从1993年到现在,过去27年,我就是这样读圣经. So in the past 27 years, that's how I study my Bible. 然后后来他又训练我们背圣经。 背圣经不是一节节的背，是一本书一本书的背。OK， 我，他这对我的生命改变非常大。Later on, Stephen Ma trained us, I mean, pray and also memorize the Bible, not by verse but by book. And this, practicing this changed my life, changed my. 这样改变了我的三观，完完全全改变了我的三观。This changed my worldview, my value system, and my purpose of life completely. Okay. 所以你也可以做。So you can do that too. 我是在我人生最忙最累的时候开始做的。I started. I started to study the Bible, to read the Bible, to memorize the Bible. In the busiest time, in the most stressful time of my life. So you can do that too. 这样的话，只会让你的生命生活越来越强壮有力。This will make your spiritual body very strong. 可以抵挡各种各样的冲击, so that you can withstand all kinds of attacks, all kinds of pressures in life. Okay. 好，我们来讲第四点. Now let's move on to the fourth step. 第四点才是讲要传递给孩子. Okay, to pass on to your children. Step four, which means the first three steps are the parents, they have to do it themselves. Okay. Okay, 传递给你的孩子. OK, 我们来看这个。 传递给你孩子，生命记六章七节，也要殷勤教训你的儿女，无论你坐在家里，行在路上，躺下起来，都要谈论。哈 Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 7, you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. 好，从这个地方你可以看见，圣经把教导孩子分成两个阶段。Here you can see that the Bible divides the our parenting stage into two stages. Okay, 第一个阶段是前面半句。The first stage is the first half of the of this verse. 他说你要殷勤教训你的儿女，看见没有？你殷勤教训就是你单向的教训他。单向的教训他，在这个教，这是，我要告诉父母一个好消息哈，你的儿女长大了，他都会嫌你很啰嗦的哈。这个阶段是上帝给你的，可以反反复复啰嗦，想怎么啰嗦就怎么啰嗦的阶段，想怎么唠叨就怎么唠叨的阶段。Okay, so the first stage is.Single direction is one direction. Basically, you just teach, you indoctrinate your children, you indoctrinate your children, and you can babble, and you can repeat, and you can repeat the same thing hundreds of times, and your children will not be tired of you. Okay, this is the only chance you have with that child that you can be mumbling, you can repeat, and your children will not be tired of you. Okay, so make the most use of it. Take the advantage of it. Do not waste it. Okay, 你要千万要记住这一点，就是这是你唯一的一个机会。你要教导哈，等一下我们会讲你教导什么东西。Okay, 但是这个是要注意。但是你用好第二个阶段，第二个阶段就是 the second stage.是你不论是你坐在家里行在路上躺下起来都要谈论，这个阶段是双向讨论。双向讨论你有没有发现，你要花时间陪你的孩子，跟他一起在家里坐着，坐着干嘛？坐着就一起吃饭呢、啊、是不是？然后就一起聊天啊，一起读书啊，行在路上干什么？一起旅游啊，一起打球啊，一起在院子里面干活啊，行在路上。躺下是什么？睡觉的时候，睡午觉或者睡什么觉，或者在我们野外的时候，两个人一起或者几个人一起躺在地上聊天啊，起来，你看见没有？也就是说，你必须要花时间陪你的孩子。但是这一段呢，你就不能唠叨了，你唠叨他烦死了，他就把耳朵给堵上了。OK, the second stage, you can see that you really have to spend a lot of time to be with your children. You spend time to sit down with them in your house. What do you sit down for? You sit down at the dinner table. You sit down and reading books together, reading Bible together. And then you walk by the way. What do you walk by the way? You go out, you go shopping together, you go vacation together, you go to the play sports together, you go on in a picnic together, and lie down, maybe in the park, maybe at home, everywhere. Anyway, you have to spend a lot of time to be with your children. Okay? 然后这个阶段记住是双向讨论。At this stage, you have to remember, it's a two directions, a bi-direction, and you have to involve your children into discussion. You cannot just stop them. You see what I mean? 所以这个阶段的话，因为孩子这个阶段他已经开始独立思考了，所以你这个阶段就不能硬灌。At this stage, usually in the stage one, 第一阶段和第二阶段，一般他的这个分界线大概在八岁左右，各个孩子是不一样的。OK, 各个孩子是不一样。OK, so the line between stage one and stage two is around 8 years old, but every kid is a little different. So you are the parents, you need to figure out yourself. 你是父母，你最了解你的孩子，所以你可以去发现哈。说到这儿，你会发现中国的家长的问题是什么？第一阶段该单向教育的时候，你不单向教育，你让这些 保姆啊，让爷爷奶奶帮你看孩子，你自己要去赚钱，你自己要去追求你自己的东西。OK， 第二阶段呢，孩子要跟你谈话，你又不跟他谈话，你又把他变成第一阶段，你拼命的单向教训，单向教训他，然后他就把他的耳朵塞住，不听你的。See the problem with Chinese parents is during the first stage that you can indoctrinate your children, you can one direction teach your children diligently.A lot of Chinese parents outsource this the precious time of your children to other people, to the grandparents, and then to the babysitters, see, and to all the training classes. And then at the second stage, when you have to discuss with your children, because now they think independently, they start to think independently. Now at this stage, and you try to,you try to indoctrinate them, and you try to use the one-way teaching, and they are sick of you. They turn their deaf ears to you. You see what I mean? 所以呢，你真的是要好好的去这两个阶段哈，就是你的孩子在家里还在你的权柄下的时候，你真的要充分的利用哈。Where your children are still under your authority, under your roof, you really have to make the most use of it. Do not waste them.Okay, money is not important. It's not as important as your children. Okay, 你的钱没有你的孩子重要。你的孩子不在乎你的钱，我跟你说实话。你的孩子真的不在乎你的钱。你就想想，你长大了以后，你在谈论你的家庭好坏，你谈论多少是钱？多半是谈论你的父母跟你的关系，是不是 ？Just think about yourself. You know, you are grown up. You are adults. When you reflect how you grow up, how much do you remember how rich your parents are? The most impressive thing is how your parents spend time with you, how they influence you, right? 所以跟你的孩子也是这样。所以真的是要多花时间影响他们，按着这个原则，就是。单向和双向教育。So parents, spend more time influence your children. Don't send them to too many classes, okay? Don't send them to too many classes. 不要送他们太多课时。我的孩子都长大了，我跟你说实话，绝大部分你从小送他们学的东西都是浪费了。说实话，没有什么用的。My children all grew up, okay? Later in life, you will find out most of the classes you send your children to, they are wasted.没有用 useless, okay. 好，现在我们来讲传递给孩子什么内容。Okay, now we're going to talk about what kind of subject or the content that you need to pass on to your children where they're still under your authority, okay. 当然你要在这个过程中要谈上帝的品格和他做事的方式哈。You need to talk about, you know, in everyday life,where you are teaching your children, where you share with your children, you have to teach them about God's attributes and his way of doing things. 第一个就是你要告诉他上帝的品格做事的方式。第二个是上帝对人的拯救和他对人的要求。Okay, and the second is God, his salvation and also his requirement of his people. Okay, 上帝其实对人是很多要求的。上帝不是对人没有要求，是有要求的。Okay.第三个你要谈这个生命的尊贵和人的败坏和诡诈。And then you need to talk about the precious of life, you know, the preciousness of life, and then human, our ultimate corruption of human being, and then all the deception. 还有很多很多的内容 and all the other subjects. 还有一个非常非常非常重要的内容，一个There's a very, very important thing is, 不断的要警告他们，他们现在生活的这个世界，各种欺骗和诱惑。There's a very important area that you have to warn your children constantly. 就是要告 that there are a lot of deception, a lot of temptation, a lot of dangers in the world that they are living.OK, 例如像进化论的影响，像马克思主义的影响，还有性别啊、性啊、种族问题啊等等，你都要谈论的。OK, so you need to talk about the evolution, Marxism, gender, sex, racism, everything. 同时呢，你就像打预防针一样，你其实要告诉他们社会上的人怎么说，他们应该怎么去应对。你要跟他们做一些就像是模拟一样的。你想打预防针是什么意思？不就是你打那个没有活性的那个病毒吗？然后帮助他认识这些东西吗？这是一回事儿，是不是 ？So also you can do while you are telling your children about the world they are living, you can do role play. Okay, just tell them what the world will see, how you are going to react, and how they are going to attack you, attack your faith, and then just like give them a vaccination. Now, what is vaccination?Just think about it. It just give them deactivated the virus so that even the deactivated virus will not make them sick, but will make them recognize the real virus, right? Okay, 我们现在孩子生长的环境是越来越有毒啊！父母，你必须要尽心尽力的去装备他们。The environment of your children is getting more toxic, and parents must diligently equip them.As I mentioned earlier, 我刚才已经提到，就是要模拟外面的世界，要跟他打预防针。I mentioned earlier, you do role play. Just tell them, if the world see this, what you're going to see. And then also tell them the vaccination, how that work, that kind of thing. Okay, you have to prepare them. So that,这样的话，当孩子到学校去，我的孩子小的时候，他们刚上学的时候回来，他们就说：“妈妈，你真对呀，他们真的这样攻击我呀。” So when my kids were little, when they go to school, they come home, and then some of them were say, "Mom, you are so right. What you told us, the attack you told us is right. That's exactly the way they attack us." Okay. Okay.圣经上其实讲了很多世界和魔鬼在跟你抢夺你的孩子，跟上帝抢夺你的孩子。The Bible said many, many times that the world and the devil are fighting against you and God for your children. So you have to stand firm on your ground. So 你必须要站稳，站稳，站稳，跟他们征战。怎么站稳 ？How to stand firm?就是我刚才讲的前面三步怎么站稳，你自己要先装备好，你要变得很强壮。怎么？你 you have to be strong first. You have to be a strong warrior to fight the war. How to prepare yourself? The first three steps in this PPT I just talked about. 好，我们看法老，他想把。不是以色列人不是要出埃及吗？法老最后说什么？啊，你们成年人都走吧，走走走走走走走，把孩子留下来。为什么？因为法老知道孩子留下了，他们就不可能走太远，因为他们的心在孩子身上。Remember, when the Lord was leading the Israelites out of Egypt, okay, Pharaoh said, "You adults, you can leave. You men, you can leave, leave, leave. Keep your children here."Keep your sons and daughters here. Because the Pharaoh know that if Pharaoh can keep their children there, they will not walk very far. They will not follow the Lord very far because their hearts are with their children. Okay. 圣经说，圣经在新约，圣经在启示录说，埃及和法老就代表这个世界，代表罪恶的世界。The Bible says in the Revelation says Egypt and the Pharaoh represent this evil world. They are fighting for our children against the God. They are fighting with us for our children. 所以我们一定要站稳，要跟他征战，要早早的准备我们的孩子啊。好，刚才说了法老哈，然后你再想想以色列北国被掳到这个亚述的时候，亚述王做了一件什么事儿？亚述王为了统治他们，把他占领的其他国家的人搞了一堆来，然后把以色列人弄了一堆走，然后把剩下的在撒玛利亚这个地方，把以色列人跟外族人弄来， 使劲一搅和，一搅和，一搅和，搅和这是什么？这就是我们现在说的 diversity 嘛，多元化嘛，是不是？是不是 ？OK, just think about, when the Lord's kingdom, Israel, Lord's kingdom of Israel, when they are captured by, Assyria. Okay, the king of Assyria, what did he do? He captured the people, the Israelites from Samaria, and then take some of them to the other land that they captured. And then they take people from other land and then brought them to the land of Samaria. And they mix these people up, mix their religion up, their culture up. So what is that? That is called diversity. Think about it. That is called diversity. Okay. 所以呢，现在这个世界上的这个亚述王，现在正在用多元化来跟你的孩子洗脑，正在用多元化跟你的孩子洗脑。所谓多元化是什么？宗教多元化，文化多元化，传统多元化，目的是什么？就是把基督信仰给它冲掉，让你对你的上帝不要再忠心了，就是这么回事。仔细想想，根源就是这么回事，根就是怎么回事。 OK, just think about this diversity. What is a diversity? Diversity means you have a mixture of all the religions, a mixture of all the culture, mixture of all the tradition. The purpose is to dilute Christian faith so that they will desensitize you and then remove your loyalty to the Lord Jesus Christ. So that is the essence of diversity. OK, they are using diversity to capture your children.他们在用多元化来掳掠你的孩子，掳掠你的孩子。所以这就为什么你平时也要在家跟你的孩子讲多元化到底是什么意思。So you must tell your children what diversity really means, in biblical term, in biblical knowledge, 按照圣经的解释，不是按世俗的解释。OK, 你看见没有？世界。媒体和学校正在拼命的，正在拼命的跟你的孩子洗脑，拼命的。See the all the mainstream media, all the media, even the social media like Facebook, you know, like Twitter. Now they control the content of the information. They are brainwash your children. And the school, they are also brainwash your children. You have to be careful.好，所谓的这个世界和孩子，世界和魔鬼抢夺你的孩子，它主要是从两个方面在做。OK, there are two areas, two key areas that the devil and the world are trying to take captive of your children. Two areas. 第一个就是他另立是非标准，麻痹歪曲。你孩子和你的良心 ，OK. The first is they will set up different standards of right and wrong. For example, they use Marxism. They use pseudoscience. For example, psychology is a pseudoscience. In most regard of the psychology, OK, it's a pseudoscience. Also, evolution is a pseudoscience. OK.然后呢，他 use set up a different standard right and wrong to surprise and desensitize the conscious, your conscious and your children's conscious. Okay, okay. 第二个是他会篡改历史，他用谎言充斥媒体。The second is where they will fabricate history and the news. They will fabricate all the facts. Why? 他为什么这样做？因为圣经说了，记住，圣经说。日光底下没有新鲜事。The Bible says there's nothing new under the sun. 所以这就为什么圣经非常注重历史。旧约就是讲历史。为什么？历史教人智慧。Okay. The Bible is very big on true history. That's why the Old Testament, a lot of the Old Testament are history narratives. Because you can learn wisdom from history. Learn lessons from history. Okay. 所以呢你看见哈，世界在扰乱，在给你的孩子洗脑，是从两个方面。第一个方面是改变圣经的是非标准。你知道，在美国以前 过去就是从六十年以前的美国的是非标准都是圣经标准。OK， 现在他的所谓的这个多元化就是要把圣经标准从美国社会赶出去。OK， 第二个就是篡改历史。篡改历史其中一个就是他，你们上网查一下，我没有时间跟你展开，你们去查一下1619 Project 和1776 Project。1619 Project 就是一个造谣 Project， 是几个黑人搞的，现在很多公立学校开始用，最近 Trump 总统要把它赶出去，这是一个就是要篡改历史。OK， 所以just to summarize， and then the world and then public school and the news media and they in the name of diversity they are trying to brainwash your children in two areas。One area is to set up a different standard of right and wrong. Get rid of, drive out the biblical standard that has been in this nation for hundreds of years, since the foundation of this nation. And they try to kick out the biblical standard of right and wrong. And they try to desensitize, suppress the conscience of your children and you. And second is they try to make up fake history facts, okay? They try to use lies and to fill up all the media, okay? 就是这两个领域，而且它都是 in the name of diversity, 都是用这个用这个多元化 ,okay? 好，我们来如果你们没有读这个小说，我真的是建议你们的孩子都读一下这个小说，如果没有读的话，这个小说是 George Orwell， 是一个英国人写的哈，他是1948年写的1984年，他不光是像过去几十年的集权的这些共产主义国家哈，他还像圣经描述的世界末日，他很像圣经描述的世界末日，我不是跟你开玩笑，因为我的圣经读了几十遍，我圣经上很多书我都读了至少100遍。你真的你自己看的话，真的像世界描述的世界末日哈。在这个1984这本书，它有一些引言，我们来看一下哈。If you or your children have never read the novel, 1948, I really recommend you, suggest you.And your children read this book, okay? 很快读的，我就是有一次坐飞机，是在飞机上读了。It's a fast reading book. I read it one time when I was taking a flight. Okay. There are some interesting quotes in this book. 它第一个就是它就是在讲另立是非标准。第二个就是讲篡改历史。关于另立是非标准的，他这样讲，他说在哲学、宗教、伦理学和政治中，也许二加二。等于五，但当一个人在设计枪支或飞机时，二加二等于四。也就是说，所有的这些关于是非标准的主观的是非标准，关于世界观的领域，他开始篡改，他把二加二等于五。Okay, it says in philosophy, in religion, and in ethics, in politics. So those are all related to worldview. Remember, those are all related to worldview and your value system and the purpose of life. And then here they make.2+2 to be 5. That's the change the standard of for you and for your children, so that your conscience is suppressed and desensitized. 这样的话，你的良心，如果你在做坏事，你跟着他一起去干坏事，你的良心都就不会打搅你了。So that once your conscience is desensitized, when you do bad things, I mean when you take their order, do bad things.And then your conscience will not bother you anymore. See? 第二个就是篡改历史。他说控制现在的人就控制过去。控制过去是什么？就是你去写历史嘛，是不是？控制过去的人就控制未来。就是你篡改历史的，你就可以写，你就可以愚弄他们，你就可以让他们按照你的要求做。就这个意思。Okay, he says, those who control the present control the past. What does that mean? That means if you control the present, means you are dominion.You have dominion, you have power in this present of time, so that you can rewrite the history to your benefit. okay? And if you control the past, if you control the past and you control the future, what does that mean? That means if you rewrite history and you can fool all the citizens, all the people, so that they will do whatever you make them to do, okay? 真的是好好读一下这个书，这个书真的我很佩服这个作者，写得真好。Really recommend this book. I really admire George Orwell. He's a genius. I really think he's a genius. 好，现在我们来讲几个例子，也就是说现在在美国社会非常非常严重的哈，可能你没有意识到哈，美国现在大学和这个小学、初中、高中，这些老师们绝大部分被马克思主义洗脑，他们很多都没意识到他们在被洗脑。绝大部分马克思主义真的像个幽灵一样，现在在美国的上空萦绕。OK，probably you do not realize that. Okay, now in the United States, most faculties in college, in grade schools, are indoctrinated, are infiltrated by Marxism. Okay, some of them did not realize that, but the Marxism ideology are controlling the U.S. education system. Okay, example one, 利益哈，利益的话，你知道，在2018年三月，亚利桑那州。他们几个年轻的老师开始了一个 Radical Ad， 就是搞马克思主义的，然后他们这个很快像星星之火可以燎原一样遍及美国，然后他们到处去游行，这全是老师，这就是你的孩子们的老师啊。 OK， example one， left wing Radical Ad teachers movement launched in Atlanta in March of 2018, by a few young school teachers. Now, this is just like a spark now spread out the whole nation. Okay. Marxism is actively, aggressively infiltrating in US education system, in grade school and in colleges. Okay. 马克思主义正在疯狂的正在入侵这个美国，已经入侵几十年了，从六十年代开始，从冷战的时候就开始了入侵美国的这个高等教育和低等教育的体系。现在就是我前一段时间专门读过一个报告，至少有80-90%的这个大学老师都是受马克思主义影响。Recently I read a few reports that says that the college faculties like around the 80s or 90s they are infiltrated by Marxism. Okay, in the past few dozens of years. 好，第二，你知道这个黑命贵的三个其创始人，三个黑非裔，三个非裔的这个女士，其中一个人在2015年的时候自己说，他和另外一个，也就是他们三个人，有两个人是受过培训的马克思主义者。Okay, example two, Black Lives Matter. Three founders, two of them, they claim themselves are trained Marxism. 你看看他们做的这个事儿。我们都是共产主义国家来的，我们对我们的这些共产主义弟兄们，在世界上的这些弟兄，像诺曼利亚、前苏联呐、柬埔寨呀、这些越南的这些，你看他们最后那个疯狂的那个程度，就像美国现在这样，差不多。Okay, we are from the communist country. Whether, we know our communist, you know, back then communist.Allies like the Romania, the Soviet Union, the Cambodian, the Vietnam, and all etc. The riot right now under BLM is basically the same as happened years ago in all those communist countries. Okay. 好，第三个例子，第三，你看，这是我在网上。这是我在网上直接 录制的，这是美国的公历，这是几天前，也就是2020年9月22日，这个在新闻媒体上多处报道，美国的公立学校都为黑命贵背书，而且走组织游行。所以你看见没有？Okay, this is the news that the mainstream media a few days ago. Okay, public schools across U.S. endorse BLM, organized protest. Okay, 所以你看见没有？现在你就会看见，因为他们两个背后的都是马克思主义，不谋而合。Okay, see, no surprise because it's Marxism is behind both of them. Okay, they are on the same boat. 好，这个我就不讲了哈，因为这个太多了。黑命就是 BLM 官方网站上的这个材料。这都是我直接择录的，我这边最这边是我打的引号，你们直接在他官方网站上，看他写的，然后我就把圣经的教导放在右边对照，然后你看一下，从官方网站你看他教导就跟我们以前的，我们在国内了解的马克思主义就是一回事儿。OK, so this table, I actually have three pages. I have no time to go into details. You can go to BLM, their official website, to read yourself. So on the left, in the quotation marks, there are the verbiage I got directly from the BLM website. And then you read them yourself, you see how similar they are to the Marxism we experienced. Or we have some experiences. I mean, if you're not old enough, and you probably have read when you're in China. Okay, 我就不讲了，这个太多了。Okay, 列宁曾经说哈，列宁说，你给我四年的时间教育孩子们，我播下的种子永远不会出去。Lenin, Soviet Union, the first leader of Soviet Union, the first communist leader of Soviet Union, said, give me 4 years to teach the children, and the seed I have sowed will never be uprooted. 所以你真的要小心啊，你天天把你的孩子送去学这学那，你就是不跟他灌输这个真的好东西，然后这些人就给他灌毒药毒品。 Parents, you really have to be careful. You send your children, you give up the precious years to indoctrinate your children. You give them, you outsource them to all kinds of training classes. And then your children will be indoctrinated by this, all this poison ideology. Okay, 列宁还说，他说，我们能够而且必须用言语在民众中播散仇恨。憎恨、憎恶和蔑视，来对付那些，对不起，那是错字，来对付那些持不同意见者。Weaken and must write in language which sow among the masses hate, revulsion, and the scorn toward those who disagree with us. 所以，列宁在讲，他们必须要散播仇恨。OK， 散播仇恨。OK， 斯大林，看斯大林说什么。斯大林说，如果我能够控制美国的电影媒体，我不需要其他东西，就可以将整个世界变成共产主义。Stalin said, Stalin, the second communist leader of Soviet Union, if I could control the medium of the American motion picture, I would need nothing else to convert the entire world to communism. 你现在看看美国的新闻媒体是不是已经被他们控制了。Now just look around. Isn't U.S. media controlled by Marxism? Or people similar to their mind? People with similar mind? Okay, 稍微说几句，就是说，马克思主义的他一些主要的观点哈。第一个就是他把人为的把它分成阶级，按照他的这个，按照他们的经济啊。这个社会的这个状况地位哈。第二就是他 制造散播仇恨，制造纷争，在阶级之间制造仇恨，散播纷争，让他们互相仇恨，然后去抢夺那些稍微他们认为富裕一些的人。OK， 不管你是怎么富的啊。第三就是他就是用这个暴力去摧毁现有的所有的传统和社会结构。Okay, some key ideas of Marxism so that you can share with your children. Okay, people are artificially divided into classes based on their financial situations, and they stir up strife, hatred, and violence between classes, and then they rob the rich. And some are not that rich. Okay, and then they use forces or violence to destroy existing tradition and social structures. 好，马克思主义让孩子跟他们的父母对立 ，OK， 现在的这个整个世俗，你看这个整个的美国的这个风气，真的就是这样，让孩子跟他们的父母对立，就是现在的这些 BLM 运动啊，让老百姓跟这个警察、执法人员对立，让这个人民跟让这个抵抗这个基督信仰，现在你会发现最受冲击的就是基督信仰。然后的目的是要毁掉这个传统，毁掉法律，毁掉现有的秩序。但是你记住哈，你只能选择马克思主义一次，然后你就不能再选择，为什么？你就失去自由了。所以我跟你说实话，我经常在想，中国民国的时候其实是上帝给了中国民国几十年非常自由的时间，这就是为什么中国民国出了那么多现在令我们羡慕的这些知识分子。但是这些人呢、啊、狂妄自大，上帝给他们机会，他们选择了马克思主义，所以他们只有那一次选择，最后他们自己没有几个落得好下场。 OK Marxism turn children against parents, turn civilian against police, and turn people against the Christ and their followers. And you can only destroy tradition, law and order. You can only choose Marxism only once. After that, you have no freedom to choose whatsoever. When I think about China, like in the early part of the last century, okay, there was a lot of freedom. So the intellectuals, they enjoy a lot of freedom. Now, you know, when we tell about their stories, we admire them. We think, oh boy, they are so great. Okay. God gave the Chinese intellectual that precious time of freedom so that they can choose. But most of them choose Marxism or they keep quiet. After that, they lost their freedom to choose. And most of them, they have a very, very sorrowful ending on earth. If you do not know the history, read about them and learn from them. Learn the lesson from them. God gave them hope. They wasted it. 他们把钱浪费了。所以现在也是上帝给我们这个机会，目前我们还有机会发生。没机会了， OK?像不像圣经上说的，马太福音说人的仇敌就是自己家里。你现在想想，现在很多这些孩子回来跟父母对着干，思想跟父母不一致，为什么？因为你父母你就放手啊，你放手啊，你放弃了你的你的这个，你把你上帝给你的机会，你就那样轻易的把它放弃了，然后就让社会，让这些魔鬼，让这些学校跟你的孩子思想给俘虏了，看见没有？ See,just like the Bible prophecy that Jesus said, in a time like that, a person's enemy will be those of his own household. The enemy, the Marxism, turned the children against their parents. Okay. And just look around. There are many sorrowful parents because your children, they are fighting with you.In ideology, in standard of right and wrong, okay, about history, about all the, you know, the world view, everything. Why? Because when they're young, we did not do our best. We did not try our best to most of us, some, I would say not all of us, but I know a lot of us, you know, we fail to put in enough effort to vaccinate our children, We fail to vaccinate our children, okay? 啊，马克思主义稍微说一下，这个人从来没有做过任何具体的事儿，没有做过任何具体的事儿，也没有赚过钱，他却告诉你怎么样去运转整个世界，给了你一套是非标准，然后现在这个标准正在冲击美国的教育系统，正在冲击美国的教育系统 ，OK。Karl Marx, this person has never done anything substantial, has ever done anything that with any essence. He never ran a company, he never held a political office, he never make any money, he never held a job, he live on other people. And now he tell you, he give you a set of standard around, give your children's teachers,a set of standard of right and wrong. And he tell you, your children, and your children's teacher how to run the society, and how to reason about history, how to write history. It's how ridiculous, how hilarious it is. 看看这想想这是多么可笑的事情。我们在中国介绍马克思，我们是说他是无神论。Okay, in China, when we introduce Karl Marx, we said he's an atheist. 实际上他不是，他是拜撒旦的，他是撒旦教的敬拜者。Okay, Karl Marx was really not an atheist. He was a Jew. He knew the Bible. He was a Satan worshipper. He gave his soul to Satan. 这个地方是他写的诗，我实在没有时间。给你们读了，你们自己上网查一下卡尔马克思写的诗。他把他的灵魂交给魔鬼，他知道地狱，他知道上帝，他知道撒旦。Karl Marx is not an atheist. He knew God. He knew about the Bible. He knew about hell. He knew about the devil. He willingly gave his soul to the devil. He sold his soul to the devil. He's not an atheist. Okay. 然后这样一个人。教我们怎么样去，在影响我们的孩子。Such a person is influence our children through influence our children's teachers. 他借着影响我们孩子的老师，在影响我们的，我们的孩子们。OK。好，我稍微说一下这个呢。我的目的呢，我想你们中国人都知道，我只是希望你们把这分享给你们的孩子哈。这个以后也会放在网上，所以孩子们也可以看。在斯大林的统治下，他杀死了他自己和他邻国的人2000万人。Under Stalin's regime, in under communism, they killed 20 million people in the name of Marxism and communism.曾经有个年轻人跟我说哈，说马克思主义和共产主义他们描述的未来那个图画特别美，为什么做出来这么邪恶 ？OK, once a young gentleman told me, he said, the Marxism and then the communism they painted the picture of the future so beautifully, but the reality, their reality is so painful.So ugly, so gross, so disgusting. OK, 这是柬埔寨。柬埔寨在1975年到1979年杀死了他自己人口的25%，四分之一。OK, 就是遵循马克思主义和这个共产主义。消灭阶级嘛。我们阶级跟阶级的斗争 ，OK， 而且是他屠杀他自己人民的经费，是我们那个国家的，共产党政府给的 ，OK， 这个是到现在他们不好意思说 ，OK， from 1975 to 1979, Cambodian communists murdered 25% of their own population in the name of Marxism and communism. And then the genocide was financially supported by the Chinese communist government. 在中国我就不需要说很多了哈，你们都知道，在中国过去从1949年，随后的几十年，几千万人非正常死亡。 几千万人非正常死亡. In China, since 1949, since the communists took over the power, tens of millions died unnaturally under communism and Marxism. 我下面只给你一个例子. Now I just give you a taste. 如果你上网查的话，你可以看见这个故事. OK, 1970年，这个16岁的这个张宏斌。 因为他妈妈在家庭里面聊天，说了一点对毛主席不恭敬的话，他第二天去举报他妈妈，结果他的妈妈在不到2个月后被公审、被枪毙，他就在旁边看着。I just give you one taste, one example of the what the communists did in China. In 1970, this boy. His name is Zhang Hongbin. When he was 16, one evening, his mother and his father and they had a private family conversation at the house. And his mother said something that's not very respectful about Mao Zedong. He reported the next day to the government against his mother. Less than 2 months later, his mother was sentenced and was shot to death by the government. 这就是我说的，马克思主义、共产主义和现在的这些洗脑的思想，正在把我们的孩子，让我们的孩子反对父母。 This is what I said. Now the brainwashing, the Marxism brainwashing is turning our children against us, against all the tradition, 也让我们的孩子反我们所有的传统。OK, 所以你的孩子每天在学校多长时间? 每天8个小时。 多少年？你想想，你在你孩子身上花了多长时间？在那之前花了多长时间准备他？在那之间花了多少时间烦心呢？Just think about how many hours your children spend in school. About 8 hours a day, right? For many years, day in and day out, month in and month out, years in and years out. How much time you spend, how many hours you spend before that to vaccinating your children. And then throughout that brainwashing period to de-brainwashing, to anti-brainwash your child. Think about it. 说实话，你跟你的孩子教那么多知识，有什么用？真的，美国烂起来了，你还知不知道？在文革的时候，在中国，所有的共产主义国家都是这样的，最后知识分子就会被打得落花流水的。你学那么多东西，最后你会很惨的。OK, think about it. If you ignore what's going on now, train your children with all the knowledge, why use it that? Just think about China. Think about all the communist nations years ago. How they treated the intellectuals. Think about it. 好，第五是把它传递给其他人. Okay. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. 好，现在我问你一个问题啊，如果你系在你的手上，你用手干啥？ Let me ask you a question. If you bind them on your hand, what do you use your hand for? You use your hand to work, right? So bind on your hand, 系在你的手上是什么意思？就是说你在你所做的一切事上，让人家一看就知道你是一个基督徒，就是你不偷工减料，你做事扎扎实实的，你做事很诚实。OK， 这就是你怎么影你就可以影响你的同事嘛。你同事看见你不一样，当他有问你的时候，哎呀，人家都偷工减料，你为什么不偷工减料？这就是你做见证的机会呀、啊。OK，So、okay. what do you use your hands for? You use your hands to work.So bind on your hand means you carry your testimony of Jesus Christ at your working place so that through your work, you demonstrate you do not steal time or energy or anything from your employer. You are a faithful worker. You are a diligent worker so that when your colleague or your boss see that you are different from your colleagues,And then sometime, and then God will give them, will open their mouth. They will ask you why you are different. And that is your opportunity to give glory to Jesus. That is your opportunity to testify about Jesus Christ, about your faith. Okay? 戴在轭上为经文。戴在轭上什么？你我们见面，我现在在这个上面跟你讲话，你首先看见我什么？你当然就看见我的恶了，是不是？ Now, so when you look at people, I mean, when you meet people, when you see people, what do you see first? Of course, your focus will be on their face, will be on their forehead. 特别是现在在疫情下，你戴个口罩，啥也看不见；戴个口罩，戴个眼镜，啥也看不见，真能看前额了，是不是？是不是？ Especially under this pandemic situation, you wear mask and you wear glasses, and what people see, they can only see your forehead, right? 所以你的 forehead 什么？ forehead 就是你这个人，人家看你，你的人格，你的病，就是你是一个什么样的人，人家看你，哎呦，一看你外表，哎呦，长得很漂亮，很会化妆，这个人是不是是个演员呢？很会化妆，是不是？ Okay, so put them on your forehead means from your being.From your person as a whole, and when people see you, and they can tell you are different, you carry Jesus on you. For example, you know, some people are very, they put a lot of energy putting on makeup, and then they wear very fancy clothes. And then when people see them, they say, oh, these people, maybe he's an actress, or he's very rich. And then see, that's how they identify you.看见没有？但是对我们基督徒来讲，就是说你的信仰真的是让人家看见你的时候，首先一看见你就觉得你与众不同。这个你的与众不同是因为你的基督信仰，就是你传递给其他人。OK, so, for us as Christians, we should not draw other people's attention to ourselves. We should always draw their attention.To our belief, to our relationship with Jesus Christ. So, 从这一节你可以看见，就是从我们的工作，从我们的为人，我们的装扮，人家一眼就看见我们。这其实就是在影响直接跟我们打交道的人，是不是？这就是在影响我的邻居啊。邻居是什么？就是直接跟你打交道，你的同事也是你的邻居，就你够得着、摸得着的人就是你的邻居。Okay, so this verse is telling us how we should influence others. We should influence others through our doing, through our being. Okay, so that when other people see us, they see us where? They see that we are very different from ordinary people. And then what makes us different is our faith in Jesus Christ. Okay?好，下一步，传递给社区和社会。Okay, step six is we shall influence society, community, and government. 他说，第六节说，你又要写在 你房屋的门框上，并你的城门上。OK, you shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. 我问你一下，你把你的信仰写在你的，这是比喻哈。This is figurative speaking. You are not really writing them on your doorposts. It's just like when you live out your faith, it's just like you are writing them on your doorposts. It's a figurative speaking. OK, 是一个比喻哈。所以呢，他说，你想一下，你的信仰写在你的门框上，给谁看？给进出你的家里的人看，什么样的人进出你的家门？你的朋友啊，你的左邻右舍呀，是不是？你的亲戚呀，你的同学呀，还有你的上下级呀，你的同事啊，是不是 ？So here it says you shall write them on the doorposts. Who will see your faith on your doorposts? People who enter your house, right, as a guest. Okay.Who? Your neighbors, your relatives, your classmates, your alumni, your colleagues, I mean, your friends' friends, you know, whatsoever. They are all your neighbors, means all the people that who might ever come to your house. Okay, see, you are going to influence the society, the community. See that? Okay.好，下一个是说你必须要写在你的城门上。城门是什么意思？如果你仔细读圣经的话，城门在圣经中出现过非常非常多次，都代表当时的政府、公共平台、法院。OK, gates or city gates appeared many, many, many times in the Bible. So next time when you read the Bible,You pay attention, you write down, you take notes of gates. Okay, gates in the Bible time is equivalent, is the government, the courts, legal courts, public square, all the public like news media, and like city hall. Okay.我们可以一起来读一下圣经哈。Let's read a few verses just as an example. There are many more than this. Okay. 马太十六章十八节，耶稣说：“阴间的权柄，记住原文是说阴间的门或者城门不能胜过他。”OK， 所以你看见没有？所以城门是指权柄，也就是指不是指。个人的权柄是指一个组织的有组织的一个群体的权柄，也就是指政府。Matthew chapter 16 verse 18, Jesus said, "I tell you, you are Peter. On this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." So gates stands for.Dominion stands for authority, stands for power, stands for government authority. Okay, it's a collective authority. Okay. 好，第二个我再讲一下，创世纪二十二章十七节哈，上帝应许亚伯拉罕，你的子孙必得着仇敌的城门。Okay, in Genesis chapter 22, verse 17, God says,I will surely bless you, and I will surely multiply your offspring as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore, and the offspring shall possess the gate of his enemies. Okay, 也是这个意思哈。下面我就不读了，这个你自己看哈，因为我这个PPT 的话，你们教会录了像，他就会看见。Okay, 所以呢。我只举了两个例子，因为时间关系。I'm not going to go through them all because of the time. Okay, you can read them yourself because your church recorded, so you can see it on PPT. Actually, there are much more in the Bible than just this. 圣经上其实讲的比这还要多很多，都是讲这个 gate 这个门是。那个时候的门是相当于我们现在的政府、法院、新闻媒体、 公共平台，所有的做生意的、成交的等等，都在城门口。圣经讲了非常多次。OK， however, gates in the Bible indicates, is equivalent to nowadays the government, the city hall, legal, courts, all the public arena, all the public squares, and the news media, everything you see that has collective power, has government power, has influential power. Okay? 好，上帝命令你必须写在你的城门上。God commands you, you shall write them on your gates. 上帝命令基督徒必须，你看见没？你要写是什么？是积极的，是主动的，去影响政府、政权和政策。看见没有 ？God commands Christians that you must, you shall take initiative, take actions, walk out, move forward.Move on to influence your government, your authority, and your policy making, and then your all the laws, the institution. 这个地方英文用的 shall， 这个 shall 就跟实践，你不许杀人那个 shall 是一个词。Remember that. 所以这是命令，不是跟你商量，不是一个选择，是命令，是命令。我再说一下，是命令。上帝命令你，从你自己做起，到影响你的家人，到你必须走出去影响政府、政策、政权，这是上帝的命令，不是一个选项。OK， God here use shall, the verb use shall. This is the same verb as used in the Ten Commandments, such as you shall not kill.So it's a command, it's not a discussion, it's not an option. God commands his children, his Christians, that you have to take initiative. You have to take action, take active movement to influence your government, your politicians, your policy, your laws, everything that's in the public arena. It's not an option. You have no choice.It's God's command. You cannot violate. You have to obey. Period. You have to obey. 所以你看见没有？我们刚才说防洗脑，圣经上说，我也没有时间跟你讲这段圣经了。但是我只是告诉你，防守最好的防守是什么？就是进攻。最好的防守就是进攻。你刚才看见没有？我讲的那段圣经就是就是生命记的，全是上帝的命令，全是让你主动的，是进攻了，全是进攻，是不是 ？OK, you see the topic. You guys asked me to talk about the defense, but in the scripture, the Deuteronomy that we just went through.It's all commands. God keeps saying, you shall, you shall, you shall. It's you have to take active action. The best defense is offense. The best defense is offense. You have to actively prepare yourself, actively prepare your children, actively go to influence others, influence your society, influence your government, influence your politician, and influence your policy, your law, everything that.In the environment that you are living in. Okay, 就是你必须你没有选择，你没有选择。Okay, 我实在没有时间，我就不讲这个以弗所书了。Okay, I have no time to dive into this. Okay, and you can read them yourself. Okay. Okay, 所以我现在讲一下什么政教分离这些年被滥用，政教分离这些年被这些敌基督的人、马克思主义者、敌基督的人滥用。而且基督徒因为你们自己不好好的读圣经，然后就也不好好读历史，就是我刚才说的，你的标准也错了，你的 facts 也错了，所以你就这么弱。为什么？因为你标准也错了， facts 也错，没有在圣经的真理上扎根。 OK, now let me talk about the separation of state and the church. And that it has been abused, has been misunderstood for many, many years. Why? Because Christian, you do not stand firm in the biblical truth. Then your standard is twisted. And also your facts are twisted too. That's why you're so weak. And you can, you have no strength to stand against this, this bully. Okay. OK， 第一修正案文字是这样说的：国会不得制定任何有关宗教信仰或禁止其他自由行使的法律，或剥夺言论自由或新闻自由，或剥夺人民和和平集会的权利和向政府请愿申诉的权利。第一修正案保护言论、宗教、新闻、集会和请愿自由，而随后在人权法案的修正案则涉及对美国其他价值观的保护，包括第二修正案携带武器的权利和第六修正案由陪审团审判的权利。Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press, or the right of the people peacefully to assemble and to petition the government for redress of grievances. While the First Amendment protected freedoms of speech, religion, press, assembly, and the petition, subsequent amendments under the Bill of Rights dealt with the protection of other American values, including the Second Amendment right to bear arms and the Sixth Amendment right to a trial with a jury. 你自己看了这个，你就会看见，这是保护人民的信仰不受政府的干扰，是单向的，不是双向的。We just read this, and you can see clearly all this law is to protect church, protect Christians from the bully of the state. It's just one direction. It's not the dual direction. Can you see that? 现在这些 bully, 这些坏蛋，这些欺负教会的这些势力，他们把这个把它反过来了。他是说保护政府不受教会的干扰。Now this bully,they revert this completely. And then they revert this and perverse it. And they said they are protecting the government from the church, which is wrong. This, the intention, our forefathers, the United States forefathers, the Christian forefathers, their intention is to protect the church from the state, not the other way around. Not the other way around, okay? Okay.我呢推荐你们去读一些东西在网上哈 ，Curtis Bowers， 我先说一下哈，我要推荐你们看一个平台，平台就是白美动态。再说一下白美，北美动态，北美动态 ，OK， 北美就是美国和加拿大哈，北美动态，这是一个完全是一个依据圣经来谈美国的时事，主要就是主要是谈美国的时事，当然也谈有时候也谈一些欧洲啊和世界，他基本上不谈国内的，免得被封了哈。所以呢，他很多其实是翻译的英文的这个资料，这个文章哈，比方说像 Curtis Bauer 啊，还有最近有很多这个非常好的这个这些基督徒领袖，比方像这个 John MacArthur 啊。还有这个James Dobson 啊，还有这个 Albert Mohler，Albert Mohler 是美兰浸信会，这个美兰浸信会在这个南方神学院的现任校长哈、啊，还有这个 Curtis Bauer， 他们都讲的都非常好，还有一个叫 Vody Balkan， 一个黑人牧师讲的，就是这个平台非常好。我再说一下，叫北美动态。微信版有，你要是在网上搜，也可以在网上找着。如果你实在需要，也可以找我哈。北美动态 我会经常在上面发表文章，不过我用笔名啊。好，我稍微说几句，我们就完了哈。为什么在美国的很多中国基督徒不关心政治？为什么？说穿了，是因为我们的三观没有被我们的基督信仰改变。耶稣其实不是我们的主，我们的原生文化才是我们的主，我们自己才是我们的主。所以这就为什么我经常说，你要好好检查一下你的信仰。中国文化的，我们的中国文化，我们一贯是我们自己顾自己啊，我们喜欢搭顺风车呀。是不是？为什么我们来美国？你自己说一下为什么来美国？哎，美国体制好了，我在美国我可以，可以就是说是很悠哉悠哉，我不需要我自己我不需要是富二代，也不需要是红二代，我就能够在美国靠我的劳动赚钱嘛，搭顺风车。你知道美国之所以成为这样的体制，是很多基督徒先辈们把它变成这样子的，而且民主的体制是这样的。民主的体制是靠每一个个人。美国的立国先父说，这个民主的体制啊，只适合那个有信仰和有品格的人。信仰是特指基督教信仰，因为美国立国先父建国的时候，98.5%是一般的这个 Protestant， 就是那种清教徒，另外1.5%是天主教徒。刚开始的时候，后来这个比例有调整。也就是说，他刚开始说的信仰就是特指基督信仰，说美国的民主是只是针对有基督信仰和有美德的人的。如果你不管理的话，像你们在明尼苏达来了那么多穆斯林，你们做什么了吗？你其实你完全可以游说你的政府啊，你知道有这么回事，你平时关心，你天天去游说你的政客，因为这些政客，你看那些闹事的人，他为什么由着他？为什么？因为就是谁叫的响，他就听谁的。所以你是基督徒，你完全去可以游说，因为这圣经上不是说了吗？你必须要把它写在城门上，也就是说你必须要去影响他，这是你的权利，也是你的责任。上帝命令你去影响，所以你看看，我们就一直往后退，一直往后退，退到最后你就没有生存的空间了。当然呢，我们等着上天堂。问题是，当你没有生存的空间的时候，绝大部分可能是你的孩子就失落了，你的孩子被洗脑了，他也不愿意再信了，你说的什么东西他听不进去了，是不是？ OK， so the reason that we Chinese Christian we live here, we do not care, I mean, about the politics, because our worldview, our value system, and our purpose of life has not been changed by our faith. Jesus is not really our Lord. Our culture and ourself is our Lord.Okay, we are governed by the Chinese culture. Chinese culture is a very selfish culture. We just want to take a free ride. Okay, take a free ride. Somebody build a platform and we just come here and then we just be an actor or actress. We don't want to start from zero. But you have to know, this platform takes time to build, also takes effort to build, also takes effort to maintain.The forefather of the United States says clearly back then that this democracy is only good for a people with Christian faith and with moral. If you have a mob, and they will use democracy to destroy democracy. Okay, just look at you, Minnesota. Why there are so many Muslims there? Because Christians...Do not stand up. You did not obey God's commandment in Deuteronomy chapter 6. God told you, you shall write it on the gates of your city. You shall influence your local government. And you did not, you failed to do that. But it's not too late now. 今年是大选年，目前我们还有一次机会，你必须要站出来做一些事儿。尽量的影响你的周围，跟你的孩子讲，跟你周围的人讲，尽量的影响。But because of God's mercy, we still have some opportunity. This year is election year. You have to do something. You 必须要选择那个尊重圣经真理的 leader. 但是现在没有啊，所以你只能选择那个 less evil, the lesser evil. Okay, 就是说你 less evil 就是你。当然现在你说这两个 这两个在台上的他都不那么好，但是你至少要看一下哪一个人的政策更坏，哪一个人的政策是更加是鼓励，更加是鼓励马克思主义，鼓励这种打砸抢，鼓励这种跟你的孩子洗脑，鼓励这种变性，摧毁这个基督教的这些传统。如果你知道那个政客不好的话，那你当然一定要选他的对手啊，因为你在这种情况下，你只能选择一个 less evil， OK。所以呢 ，under current situation, God at God's mercy, He gave us the opportunity. Okay, we have to do something to influence our children, influence our neighbors, influence anyone that we can influence. Okay, and then we have to choose the less evil candidate. 说实话，现在在美国的这个政坛上，这两个党，以前两个党啊。他们的差别不是很明显，这次两个党的差别太明显了，一个简直是邪恶到家了。Okay, in the past, the two parties, their difference is not so obvious, but now it's so obvious. One party is just utterly evil. Seriously, it's just utterly evil. I have no time to dive into all the details. Okay, you just have to do something. Okay, follow God's command. 好，我今天就讲到这个地方，我讲了俩小时了，我先把它给